often been obscure and give faces, literally and metaphorically, to a segment of the teen population that has too long been invisible. Speaking with equal impact to both the reader's heart and mind, Beyond Magenta is highly recommended. Here for Susan. So we thought we'd start out today by letting each of them talk a little bit about their book. Reading, Susan's going to read a little bit from her book. Liz is going to talk about her book a little bit. And then we'll just start with some questions. And then you guys are going to be asking some questions as well. So start thinking in your head of what you want to ask them.
And everyone is required to ask a question. You actually can't leave this corral until you ask one. So think of a good one. Hello, I'm Liz Prince. I'm here today talking about my graphic memoir, Tomboy. It's a story about my childhood growing up and the way that gender stereotypes kind of were enforced by the children that I was interacting with way more than the adults that I was interacting with, and how damaging those things could be and how pervasive they can be. I kind of tried to focus on the fact that children are kind of the biggest gender enforcers at a time in their life when you would think that they wouldn't have such strongly formed opinions about what makes someone a boy and what makes someone a girl. As someone who grew up very much as a tomboy and preferred things that were for boys, I got a lot of flack from other children who didn't understand why I wasn't participating in my gender role. Thought it would be fun to tell this story as a comic because comics are the way that I communicate. It was a book that I wrote and drew entirely in a 9-month period from start to finish, which was kind of a crazy marathon for me. I'm used to drawing more short autobiographical comics that are kind of more like gag strips about things like relationships or dating or my cats. Doing a longer graphic novel that was all on one theme of gender really kind of helped me contain the story and make it not be like a 5,000 page book just about my childhood. And so I found the process to be kind of similar to drawing short comics in that there are a lot of smaller vignettes that are connected to the larger narrative of gender and how those kinds of things impacted my life as I was growing up. It's unfortunate that I can't show actual panels from the book while I'm talking to you because I feel like the art is a big part of the storytelling. But I thought it would be a great medium to convey this story. I haven't seen another graphic novel that's really so focused on gender in this way and on gender from the standpoint of someone who is still straight or cisgender. And a lot of people have kind of questioned why I wrote this book, as I am still a woman and I am a straight woman. And I've kind of found that I get stereotyped not only as people expecting me to be more girly than I am, but people expect me to be a lesbian just because of the way that I dress or present myself. So that is also part of like the larger gender stereotype that I'm kind of trying to attack in this book.